My name is Kirsten Hodge, and I'm a volcanologist and science educator.
I'm Dominique Weiss. I'm a geochemist.
My name is Kendra Kritz, and I am a geochemist and paleoecologist.
My name is Gabriela Clara Rutt, and I'm a glaciologist.
My name is Anais Orsi. I'm a polar climate scientist.
My name is Yaila Sezginer, and I'm a biological oceanographer.
My name is Kate Smith. I'm an environmental chemist.
My name is Valentina Radic. I'm a glaciologist and a geophysicist.
My name is Sarah Harris, and I'm a scientist who studies how people learn climate science.
My name is Hazel Wong, and I am an engineering geologist and a wildland firefighter.
My name is Annie Bork, and I'm a volcanologist.
My name is Rachel White, and I'm an atmospheric and climate scientist.
My name is Rosie Howard. I'm a research associate and team leader in atmospheric science.
I'm Maya Kapalova, geologist.
My name is Catherine Raymond, and I'm a hydrogeologist.
My name is Susan Hollingshead, and I'm a professional geoscientist.
My name is Amy Chan. I'm a marine microbiologist.
My name is Stephanie Waterman, and I'm a physical oceanographer.
My name is Sarah J. Oliva. I'm a seismologist.
My name is Louise Longridge. I'm a paleontologist.
My name is Megan Russell, and I'm a planetary scientist.
My name is Leah May Vare, and I'm an oceanographer.
Find yourself a good network of support, which also includes good mentors. These are people you can ask questions to, people who will be your advocate, people who will assist you at every step of your academic career.
Don't be shy. Don't underestimate yourself.
Embrace your differences. Science works best when people from all different backgrounds, with different ways of thinking, different approaches, different perspectives, get together to solve problems. And you have a lot to add to that.
To seek out others who are interested in the same areas as you. These sorts of people can be a great support to you on your journey.
Search for ways to collaborate with people who think differently than you do, and never be afraid to ask for help.
You can pursue whatever topic makes you the most excited. And if that image of how you see that kind of scientist doesn't really fit how you see yourself right now, please don't let that stop you. If anything, it might just mean that you have a new perspective to provide in that field, and then that can make you extremely valuable.
Come with an open mind, prepared to learn new ideas, new perspectives, but at the same time, don't forget to trust yourself, your instincts, your own values.
Don't be afraid to keep asking questions. Also, keep persevering and trust your gut.
Remember that failures are inevitable part of science. However, don't let that discourage you. Look at the setbacks as learning opportunities. Don't give up and always believe in yourself.
You can be a scientist, no matter what path you take to get there.
Also remember that even if you aren't sure exactly where your path in science is going to take you, just start out with the first step. Then keep going one step at a time. It won't be long before you look back and realize you've gone so far.
Take chances and keep an open mind. Don't be afraid to take different approaches or to change directions if you think you're on the wrong path.
Be curious all the time.
If there is anything you feel that is crossing your path or that is not fair, put your red boots. And if you want to know what putting your red boots means, feel free to send me an email.
Always shoot your shot and don't be afraid to put yourself out there.
Do not forget to have fun.
When you choose your research subject, think not only about the science and the topic, but also about the people who work in one or another lab. It is the character of these people who make your research experience enjoyable or not.
Have the courage to explore what you want and pursue what you love, because you'll never know where it could lead you.
Don't be afraid to ask questions in your classes or even point blank email someone whose work you're interested in.
Science is exciting, and with so many new discoveries to be made. So get out there and explore the world.
Run your own race. I personally juggled having two small children as I navigated becoming a professor, and I found great strength in seeing the race as my own and as seeing it as a marathon, not a sprint.
If you can, try your best to find some science-related work experience, maybe during your summers. It's going to really help you learn what you like to do, what you don't like to do, and make it so much easier to get your first job post-graduation.
Always pursue the subjects that are interesting to you.
Never lose your curiosity about the world around you, and try not to take yourself too seriously.
Let them tell you no. Don't let yourself be crippled by self-doubt. If you're interested, just go for it and I'll work out.
Spend energy on collaborations that make you feel good and don't waste time on those that don't. Work to surround yourself with good people that you enjoy working with and that add value to what you do.
Feed your curiosity and surround yourself with people who support you.
To be confident and to stay curious. Never be afraid to reach out and ask someone for advice. Whether that's on school choice, questions about science or research or career mentorship, there are many people who would be happy to help you become a scientist.
Just be yourself. We need diversity in science. More diverse scientists makes better science. So don't be afraid to be who you are.
And always remember that there's a place in science for everyone, including you.